Hi guys, got my Benchmade hat on today, and that can only mean one thing. We've got a couple of knives to review from Benchmade. This has been a long time coming. I haven't reviewed these and loads of other people have, so I thought it's about time to get my butt in gear and get these done. And they came out in some new colours very recently. I actually had a look at these at the last SHOT Show I went to, and then again I had a look at them at Iwa. I finally got round to getting a couple, one in standard and then the other in the new small format. It is of course the Bugout and the Mini Bugout. Finally, I've entered into the world of very thin, very slicey and incredibly lightweight. So we'll start with the standard Bugout. It's a folder, obviously, with some thumb studs on there. So hopefully this isn't going to be a huge problem if you're shipping them in from anywhere to the UK, because we know that they're pretty good with thumb stud opening. And if not, you can buy these from UK distributors anyway. I'll put a link up. Heine sell them in the UK, so I'll stick a Heine link up on there. And it is with the Benchmade Axis lock, which a lot of other companies have now gone on to copy or bring out their, you know, version of. This is what they call crater blue. Give you a close-up of that. Grivery handles in crater blue, beautiful color. And then you've got this kind of desert coating on here, sort of desert tan color, or like a bronzy color. Really pretty. It's actually this one stood out to me as kind of being the prettiest option available, because I just love that blade colour. Really cool. Give you a bit of a close-up. And then, of course, you just can action it with that axis lock. So you can also sling it out with the lock, put it away with the lock. Needs a bit of a flick of the wrist. But to be honest, I actually prefer just bringing it out with the thumb studs, nice and easy, very smooth. It did actually take a while to loosen up, and from what I can understand, you know, a lot of knives are like that. If they've got a coated blade, then the coating just takes a while to kind of work in. You just open and shut them a few times, and eventually they just loosen up really nicely. So obviously it's hella thin, we can all see that, and it just sits in the pocket virtually unnoticed. Benchmade quality, as you would expect. Really nicely centered blade, and very nicely put together. And it is super light. So this is coming in at 55 grams, which is very light, guys. Really good. Just disappears when you carry it, basically. So if you're doing things that require, you know, minimal weight of kit, you're doing expeditions and stuff where ounces make a difference, then I would thoroughly recommend this. We've got a bit of jimping there, which is obviously useful when you're using it, because you can put your thumb there and get a nice bit of leverage. And then it's got actually a very nicely shaped handle, not particularly any serious hot spots on there. Being thinner, you know, and a sort of minimalist design, it's not, you know, the most comfortable handle in the world, but considering the trade-off and how much weight you're saving and how much size you're saving, you know, that it's not bulging in the pocket or anything like that, then I would say it's very comfortable indeed. Now, there have been some people talk about the flex on these Grivery handles, and you can see there that there is a tiny bit of flex, but it's nothing serious. You know, I'm not going to be, you know, there sort of snapping this in half or using it to like lever things out. I would never use a folding knife for stuff like that. If I wanted to do that, I would bring a great big fixed blade or an axe or a pry bar. I wouldn't be using one of these. This is for, you know, lighter tasks than that. And if you're using it properly, that isn't really an issue. You know, I've got pretty strong hands, and I'm sort of squeezing that in the middle. It's not creating any serious issues for me at all. It certainly doesn't create any noticeable play in the blade. You know, the blade is locked in there nice and firm, so I've got no issue with that. The blade itself is 3.24 inches or 8.23 centimeters. And then the thickness is 0.9 of an inch or 2.29 mil. And the handle thickness is only 0.42 inches or 10.67 mil. Drop point style blade. And it's been Cerakoted. So Cerakote is a really, really good treatment. It's not cheap, Cerakoting. So that's what you'd expect from Benchmade. And then we've got that nice pocket clip, which is pretty damn deep carry. It's a pretty minimal pocket clip, as you'd expect. Again, that's what this thing is all about. And then we've got a lanyard hole on the back, should you need to strap a lanyard through it, which if you're doing adventuring and you need all your lightweight kit, then you may well be doing that and sort of sticking it in a pocket and just lanyard it in case it fell out and fell down a mountain or something. Then I'm sure you would want to make sure that didn't happen. But fit and function, it's absolutely superb. Really, really like it. It's very, very fiddly. You know, I find myself sort of playing around with it quite often. I like the fact that the blade isn't too sloppy when I shut it. It's very predictable. You know, sometimes I just have to knock it shut. What I don't want is it just falling shut, because it is such a kind of lightweight knife that I don't want it just flipping about all over the place. It's not that kind of knife for me. And to give you an idea, you know, one of the smoothest, quickest shutting actions that I've ever used is the CJRB Pyrite. And these two aren't a world apart in terms of, you know, blade size. You can see there, quite similar size and shape. But of course, thickness wise, it's a whole different ball game. And weight wise, you know, this one is absolutely heavier. This is of course a button lock, and I absolutely love this knife. And you can see how it just drops shut. Drops shut without any sort of requirement from me at all. It literally just falls in on itself. Whereas this one, you know, I can shut it, but it needs quite a flick to do so. But for this style of knife, I actually prefer that. For this one, which is kind of you know, a fiddle fest for me more than anything, I quite enjoy that style, but they've both got their place. You know, neither's wrong, and you might prefer one over the other. This will probably loosen up a little more over time, but I actually quite like the fact that it's, you know, a definitive action that I have to kind of put a bit of effort into to close it properly. I don't want it just flopping around. Then the newer version is, of course, the Mini Bugout. So here we go with another great colour scheme from Benchmade, which reminds me of Star Wars and Stormtroopers, which is why I picked it. The Mini Bugout in white and black. So it's got that black Cerakote on there, and then matching black screws and a black axis lock on there. It's basically a scaled down variant. So you can see we've got the gym pin on the back, the grivery handles. It's handling pretty much the same. Really, really fast little action on these. I actually find these minis are kind of an even faster action than the larger one. I think just because probably the blade size really lends itself to kind of being flicked out super quickly on these. And as you can see, closing around about the same speed. So it's a nice definitive close on there. It won't just drop shut on you. You have to actually give it a bit of a flick to get it to shut. But yeah, really nippy to get out. And this one is even lighter still. So the Mini Bugout is coming in at 42 grams. It's over 10 grams lighter than its predecessor. Drop point blade. Both of these in S30V steel. So the steel on these is absolutely excellent. No one's going to be moaning about that at all. Again, a very slicey profile. Very, very slim. 2.82 inch blade, 7.16 centimeters. And again, blade thickness 0.9 of an inch, 2.29 mil. Handle thickness 0.412 an inch, 10.46 mil. Also rocking the lanyard hull and the deep carry clip on there. Again, keeping it simple and light. And I actually really like these clips. You know, they're really robust. They're well made. They're nothing fancy, but they just really do a good job. What I also like about both these knives is they haven't got really sharp parts on the thumb studs. The thumb studs actually feel nice. You can action them and they're not like ripping into your fingers or tearing half your nail off. Feels good in the hand. Again, they've taken the form factor down, but even in my hand, that is really, really easy to hold. No particular hot spots there. That's pretty comfortable for me. And on both knives, of course, you can go left or right side carry. You haven't got a choice for tip down carry. You know, it's going to be tip up carry, but you have got a choice of either side on there. And that's the same on the standard Bugout, as we can see. So, out of these two, which one do I actually prefer? Well, it's hard to tell. You know, I absolutely love both of these knives. I think if I was going camping and I wanted something as just a food prep tool, I would probably take the standard Bugout, just because that length of blade lends itself a bit better for food prep, you know, for chopping up your steaks with and cutting up apples and things like that. It's absolutely ideal. And I really like this blade for that because it's so thin and so slicey. You know, if you use a lot of EDC knives to do that kind of work, you know, especially for fruit and veg, it actually just breaks the apple away because the blades are too thick. You know, they've overbuilt them for like more robust tasks, so they're not ideal for food prep. This one, I would say, lends itself much more as a sort of small EDC option. Obviously, in the UK, that bears some problems because it is locking. It's got the axis lock, but there are many countries that don't have that sort of discrimination. And also in the UK, if you've got a job or a reason to carry, then of course you can do. You just must be sure that you're happy to prove that in court if you so needed to. So if I needed, you know, something to take fishing and cut a bit of line and do some basic stuff while I was out, or I was going off into the woods and messing about for a couple of days and not, you know, on a significant lengthy trip or anything, I would definitely take this just because it's so light. If you're a climber, for example, this might be of interest to you because it can easily be utilized with one hand and it's very, very sharp. If you needed it to just cut through some rope or something and then have minimal weight on you, this would be absolutely ideal. And the same if you're in military or law enforcement, this might be ideal for you guys because you just want a light option. You don't want more kit weighing you down with all the other stuff that you're carrying. You're probably not carrying this, you know, as some kind of badass defensive tool. You're carrying it more for its, you know, utility and usefulness as an EDC piece. So I would generally suggest that those guys would get great benefit out of that and benefit from the weight saving especially. If, like me, you just like Benchmade stuff, then I would say buy both of these. I love Benchmade stuff now. You know, I hadn't really utilized much of it before, but I really, really like the brand. People talk about the Benchmade tax. You know, yeah, they may be a little bit more expensive than some other options on the market, but the quality is there. You're looking at around 167 for this on Heine, 167, which I don't think is outrageous. I say that a lot. You know, I don't review things that are outrageous on here. If a knife costs, you know, £999 or something, which there are stuff like that out there, that's not the sort of stuff that I'm interested in. They are obviously more collector's pieces. I'm more interested in functional pieces. But I also steer clear of stuff that costs like 10 quid, you know, gas station knives and whatever, because they just don't last, you know. But there's plenty of stuff in the 30 plus pounds category. There's some really, really nice stuff in that. I mean, this the Pyrite, you know, is one option that is very, very reasonable. I think they're about 40 to 50 pounds and they're very good pieces indeed. But you know, these are a bit more expensive. Yeah, granted, I get that, and I'm sure you are paying some sort of premium because of the branding, just the same as you would if you bought a pair of Nike trainers versus a pair of non-branded trainers. But I like the styling. I really, really like the ergonomics. And I think that they were pretty innovative with these. You know, they were bringing something onto the market that was a little bit different, very, very lightweight, very minimalist in its design. And for that reason, you're going to pay a little bit of a premium for that innovation as well. Guys, I hope you found that useful. I really like these two. I would suggest you check them out if you get the chance. And if, like me, you like Benchmade, they're definitely worth adding to your collection if you haven't already. If you were like me and you were waiting and on the fence and kind of looking at reviews and people were saying, oh, but the handle flexes and all this kind of stuff, I seriously wouldn't worry about that. Just go out, get one or the other or both and stick them in your Benchmade collection. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a great weekend. I'll catch you all soon.